Hey everybody, I know the screen's a little crooked. I just want to pop this up because I know some of you are joining on. No, it is live. Hold on. Give me 1 second. I gotta fix the screen really quick. We are live. It's just you commented on like an older video. I just put it up, so I'm live now. Okay, bye. All right, I'm just gonna fix the screen really quick and then we're gonna get it going because I see that the screen is crooked. All right, so hopefully that's better for you guys. And, oh, now I know why I had it tilted. Okay, give me 1 second. I have to adjust the screen and then we're gonna get going. Because I was like, why is it all wonky? And then I tried to fix it and I shouldn't have fixed it because I actually did originally know what I was doing. Randy tidy. Okay. And now I'm going to go like that. Now you guys can see my mat. Yes. Okay. Awesome. All right. Now we're ready to go. Okay. So if you have a block and a strap, that would be ideal. If you don't, not totally necessary, but it will definitely help you with tonight's stuff. All right. Oh, Elizabeth. Hey, Elizabeth. And Monica. And I think my mom's going to be on too. And Amina just came in. Come in, Amina. Oh, good. We got a full house today. So Monica is on the live because she had to stay home today. So we're just going to wait for Amina to roll out her mat, and then we'll get going. Take your time. Don't rush. Turn this a little bit lower. How are you?
I'm good.
Oh, I'm so glad everyone's back to yoga because it was a couple weeks of it just being me and Elizabeth. Right, Elizabeth?
I know.
So what did you do? It was busy. It got busy. It got cold and it got busy, yeah. Right?
Yeah, I know.
Just... Amina, do you want a block?
Yes.
Okay.
I haven't got anything.
No, I'll grab you one. There you go. And I have a good plan for today, so hopefully we get warmed up enough to do it. I think you guys will get it. All right, so if you have your block, go ahead and sit on your block. Let me just call my mom really quick because I know that she wanted to too. And I'm going to call my mom, Monica, because I think she might have done the same thing as you. I think she might have saw a past video and thought it was the live. Hey, are you joining? No, because there was an older video, but then the live went up a little bit later, so I just wanted to make sure that you were refreshing and that you saw the actual live. Okay, all right, that's fine. All right, bye. Okay, let's get started. So as I had said, if you have a strap and a block, it'll help you. If you don't have it, it's not totally necessary. So sitting on your block. Does anyone else feel like they're rushing a lot lately? Is it just me? I feel like I'm like, maybe it's like COVID and then things sort of starting to get to normal. I can't like adjust to time. Like I was like driving here like a maniac and I'm like, I live 3 minutes away. Like how am I was never late for anything. And now lately I just feel like I'm running
normal.
Late.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah. All right, but we're here. So allow yourself to settle in. Taking an inhale through your nose and out your mouth. And just allow yourself to settle. 6:15, we're not starting late, we're all here. So just let it go. You've arrived on your mat. Taking a deep inhale in and exhale it out. Allow yourself to be a little bit fidgety if you need to. Allow yourself to breathe deep if that feels good, or breathe a little bit shallow if that's where you're at so far in your breath. Finding your space. Finding your calm. Finding this moment on the mat. taking a couple of rounds of breath in your own time. Allowing your body to still. And allowing your mind to settle. Let's take one deep inhale together. Open mouth, exhale, sigh it out. Bring the hands to Anjali Mudra, prayer position in front of your heart. As your eyes blink, then gently open, taking a moment to welcome yourself to your practice. And now you can stay on your block if you'd like, or you can come off your block. I tend to like to come off the block right after just because I feel like it's not the most stable for my spine, but that just might be me crazy in my head. So if you'd like to stay on it, stay on it. Take an inhale, reach your arms all the way up. Exhale, reach the fingertips down towards the mat. Inhale, reach those arms all the way up, look up. Exhale, look down, bring the arms down. One more time, inhale, reach those arms up. Exhale, head looks down, arms come down. Float the arms about parallel to the mat. Thumbs are up. And just doing circles for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Reverse. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Palms are up. Bring your fingers in. Reach your arms up. Fingers down and open. Fingers up. Reach up. Fingers down and open. One more time. Fingers in. Reach up. Fingers down and open. Fingers in. Slowly bring the elbows together. I was going to let you finish it. I was just going to let you go through the thing. Circles forward for 3. Trying to get those elbows to touch. 4 and 5. And then reverse it. Elbows to touch if you can. Elbows to touch. I know it might not work for everybody, but trying to get them to touch. I hear like a whole bunch of creaking. We're going to do it one more time. All right, arms can come down. Walk your fingertips out towards the right. Reach your left arm up and over. Doesn't matter which side you do, just do the opposite. Sometimes I mirror you guys, sometimes I don't even come close. So just do one side and then the other. Inhale, walk your opposite fingers out. Other arm sweeps up and over. Beautiful, and back. Lace your fingers, reach the arms out straight. Now try to get your elbows straight before we move from this. So roll the shoulder blades back, straighten the arms, and then sweep the palms up, hands behind the head. Squeeze the shoulder blades, open up the chest here, pull your elbows back, take an inhale. Exhale, curl the chin towards the chest, elbows collapse in. Inhale, open. Exhale, collapse in. One more time, open it up. Exhale, collapse in. Bringing yourself into tabletop. Or onto tabletop. I don't know. Into tabletop, onto tabletop. Okay, fingertips are towards the top of the mat. Make sure those inside elbow creases are pointing out. Take an inhale here. Drop your belly button low to the ground. Lift your chin up. Exhale, push the mat away. Curl for your cat. Inhale, cat. Exhale, cat. And flat back. Flip your fingertips towards the wide edges of the mat. And sway side to side, getting into the wrist a little bit. All right, now staying here, if this is the full rotation of your wrists, or if you can, fingertips back towards your knees. Take an inhale here, try to push into the hands, keep the arms straight as you lift the chin. Exhale, curl, push the mat away. Inhale all the way up, pushing into the ground. Exhale, curl, push the mat away. Coming to your flat back, turning both fingertips back towards the front of the mat. But now you're gonna flip your right hand so it's palm up. Yeah, and just get into that forearm a little bit. This is such a hard stretch for me. Do you feel it?
Yeah.
See, I feel like some people don't feel it at all, but this is like so tough on my forearms. Just move a little on the wrist there. And then release it, that fingertip towards the top of the mat, flip opposite hand.
This one is
better on that side?
Yeah.
Mine are the same on both sides. There is no better. All right, tuck the toes under, send the seat back towards the heels, walk those fingertips forward. All right, now keeping your chest really low here, pop up on your fingers and gaze forward. See if you can start to feel the shoulders opening up as you lower your chest down. Keep your gaze forward. Keep your gaze forward. And then release the head down. Walk those fingertips a little closer towards the top of the mat if you can, giving your length in your spine, length in the armpits. And then release the forearms down to the mat. Taking three breaths here, inhale, and exhale, squeeze your shoulder blades together, see if you can lower your chest a little bit closer to the ground, inhale, exhale, one more inhale, and exhale, gaze forward at your thumbs, pull yourself forward. Coming into your baby cobra, toes are flipped under, hands are at your chest, lift up, and lower. Press into the hands, lift up to like halfway cobra, so not full cobra. Bend in those elbows and pull the chest forward. And lower down. Bring the forearms forward into your sphinx. Tuck the back toes under. Pull the heels back. Pull the chest forward. Like you're like stretching yourself apart. And release. Reach your right arm forward. Full rotation back towards your booty. Forward and down. Left arm comes forward. Full rotation back. Forward and down. Right arm forward and back. Forward and down. Left arm forward and back. Forward and down. Bring the right foot in. Right hand back. Now, I know this is really early for this, so if you need to grab your strap, grab your strap. I know this is super, super, super early. So this might feel pretty terrible. We're just working into that thigh. And release, bring it forward. Left foot comes in, left arm reaches back. Pull the foot in. And release it. Forehead comes down to the mat. First spatula. So right arm out to the side, right ear down. Left foot, yeah, comes up and over. Press into that left hand. See if you can open the chest up a little bit more. And back to center. Switching sides. Left arm out to the side, left ear down, right foot up and over. And back to center. Hands come to your chest, tuck the toes under, seat comes back. Taking a child's pose, press into the hands, down dog. Pedaling out your feet in down dog. Coming on tippy toes, lowering the heels, any kind of movement that feels good to you early on. All right, now we're gonna do my least favorite stretch. It used to be cat-cow, but now it's this. But we're working on it. Okay, so walk your feet in one step if you need to. Slight bend in the knees if you need to. Take your left hand, bring it to the left, or the right, sorry, the right, either ankle, I can't reach the ankle, I have it more towards the calf. And then press into that right hand, look up underneath the right arm. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, release. Right hand to left, twist and pull through, inhale, exhale, inhale, and exhale. Bring the right hand down, lower the knees down, take a child's pose. How'd that feel?
Good.
Amina, did you like it?
My right side is better than my left.
I hate it. So hard for me. So hard.
I know.
I have no idea why, but it is the hardest thing for me. Alright, come back into your tabletop. Reach the right toes back. Reach the left arm forward. Actually, bring the left arm like down to the ground, but up towards the top of the mat, so that your arm is replicating what your back foot is doing. Now lift up, lower all the way down. Lift up, lower all the way down. Lift up, lower all the way down. Lift up, flex the back foot, and now we're gonna try to do that donkey kick up with the arm in balance, okay? So if you can't, you can bring that hand down. There's no shame in that. Just working on the balance and the donkey kick at the same time. Inhale, lift, lower, lift, lower, lift, lower all the way down. Left foot comes back. Right arm creeps forward. Lift up and lower. Lift up and lower. Lift up and lower. Lift up, flex the back foot. Right arm is just reaching forward. It doesn't really move. Your back foot kicks up, lower. Kick up, lower. Kick up, lower all the way down. All right, coming off of the hands for a minute. Come to sit on your toes. Sorry, fire toes. I should have said that. Pick those toes out. Now, I know for some of you this is really, really hard. Amina, just stay up high. And actually, if you're this early in your practice, if this is too much on your ankles, just stay high. Just work on like kind of putting the weight back on the toes so you can get into the feet a little bit. And just taking two breaths here. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Untuck the toes. And walk the hands back. Lift the right knee. And lower. Lift the left knee. And lower. Do right and left again. Or lift both. If you're doing right and left, keep doing right and left. If you're holding both and you want to try next level, reach the hands forward. Inhale. Exhale. Yeah! Inhale. Exhale, knees down. Nice. Take a child's pose. That was just like a little quick fun ankle opener. It wasn't anything. If you didn't do any of it, that would have been fine as well. Pull yourself forward onto your belly. Inhale, baby cobra. And lower. Exhale, full cobra. See if you can do your full cobra now or a little bit more open. And lower down. Tuck the toes under. Child's pose. Down dog. Walk your feet all the way up to the top of the mat, moving slowly and deliberately. When you get to the top of the mat, bring those feet about hips distance apart. Deep bend in the knees so that your belly button is resting on your thighs. And grab opposite elbows. And hang in that forward fold. Sway a little bit if you'd like. And now see if you can straighten the legs and bend. Straighten the legs and bend. Straighten the legs. Keep them straight this time as you lace your hands behind your back. So lace those hands. Bring the palms together and then straighten the arms. Up towards the ceiling. Head is reaching towards the ground. Pull the shoulders away from the ears. Hang in that forward fold. Let's take two breaths here. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Now keep your fists laced. Tuck your chin to your chest. Curl all the way up. When you get to the top, let the weight pull you back a bit. Gaze up towards the ceiling. And then release it. Huge arm circles in your shoulders. Go one. Oh, I'm not even in. Sorry, guys. I'm like not even in the frame. Well, that's okay. You guys get what I'm doing. Arms back for one, two, three, and forward for one, two, three. Beautiful. I'm going to slide it back because I feel like that's weird. It's just like focusing on my... Okay, that should be good. All right. Right? Closer. Okay. Sorry, I'm like freaking out now about it because I don't want it to just be on my chest. Okay, that should be good. All right. There we go. Okay. Inhale, reach the arms up. Exhale, forward fold all the way down to the ground. Inhale, take a halfway look up. Bend those knees. Pull your head forward. Exhale, forward fold. Now, it's okay if the hands don't make it to the mat. Bend the knees so that your hands do get there. Step the right leg back into your low lunge. So the hands are down either side of that left foot, reaching the back foot back, and then tap the back knee and lift it. Tap the back knee and lift it. Tap the back knee, untuck the toes. Inhale, reach your arms up. So reach your arms up towards the ceiling first. See if you can get the arms in line with the ears. Send the hips forward. Then reach the arms back, but move your head with it. So keep those arms in line. And bring the arms down. Tuck the back toes under. Walk yourself back. Flex those front feet. Now today, try not to go all the way down. Try actually to stay up as high as you can while still getting that front leg straight. Good. And walk forward. Untuck the foot. Keep your hands down, but lift your chest. See if you can get the stretch into the thigh here. And then move in slow. Walk it back, but stop yourself. Don't lower all the way down. Keep yourself high. And walk forward. Good. Right hand stays down onto the mat. Right foot comes up. Left arm reaches back for that right foot. Draw it into the hip first for a breath. Inhale. Exhale. Now push the top of the foot into the hands. So you're pushing that back foot back and drawing it in with your hand. Does that make sense? So it's like doing an opposite kind of movement. The hand's trying to get it close to the butt. The foot's trying to get it down towards the ground. And then release the foot down. Lift that back knee back up. Inhale, reach the arms up. Coming back into your high lunge. Step your foot forward. Reach the hands up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway look up. Exhale, forward fold. Bend the knees to get the hands down. Left foot steps back. In our low lunge here, tap the back knee and straighten. Tap the back knee and straighten. Tap the back knee and straighten. Tap the back knee, untuck the toes, reach the arms up. So before we move into our Anjanasana, same thing. Reach those fingertips up first. Bring them in line with your ears. Send the hips forward. And then reach the arms back. Make sure you're engaging the entire body. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. And exhale, bringing the hands back down. Tuck the back toes. Reach that top foot. Now same thing, stay high. Squeeze the shoulder blades back, pull that chest forward, and then walk it forward. Untuck the foot, lift the chest. And walk it back. Flex those feet up, lift the chest here, still. And walk it forward. One more time, we walk it back. And forward. Tuck the back toes under, lift the back knee. Arms come back up, high lunge. Step it forward. Okay, now, we are gonna grab straps. If you don't have a strap, you can grab a pair of leggings. Honestly, you can do the entire exercise without anything. The strap just helps in terms of resistance. So, as you're pulling the strap apart, you're engaging the muscles. So it becomes shoulder, it opens the shoulders up more because of the resistance. But you don't need it. You can do the same rotation in the shoulder and it's still gonna help you. Or you can grab a pair of leggings and just hold your leggings up this way. Okay, so shoulders distance apart. Taking it, so the entire time squeezing the strap apart. Inhale, reach your arms up. And back towards your ears. Not all the way back, just back towards your ears. And down. Inhale, reach your arms up. Just up to the ears, maybe slide them behind the ears. And down. One more time, inhale, reach up. Now this time reach up high first. And then see if you can slide them back. Move the head forward. And down. All right, now this time I'm gonna set my feet a little bit closer because I didn't realize they were like super far apart. So you just have your feet hips distance apart. Inhale, reach the arms up. Now pull the strap apart, lean to the right. So pull, 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 pull. And back. Pull, 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 pull. Opposite side. And back. Reach the arms down. We're gonna go a little bit wider, like so that your arms can make a Y in the air. But I guess down it's like a V. Okay, inhale, reach those arms up. And then elbows come in. Now, pull the strap back. So you're pulling, 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 opening up. You should feel all along the chest. Pull, 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 pull apart and pull back for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Reach up and down. All right, that's it for the strap. A little bit of drop backs so that we can get into our upper body. Now, if you, Elizabeth, I know has heard me go through this whole spiel, but if we haven't done drop backs, I don't think I've done drop backs with you and Monica. So, a drop back is in yoga when you see people, and this is not actually what we're doing because I can't actually do it, but drop back is when people go from standing and can go all the way back into like their wheel pose. So they're like dropping back, right? Now we're not actually doing that, but we're gonna, same thing as fairy dogs, we're gonna work on the mechanics of what that is. Because a lot of people go into back bends, dumping into their lower back. So we wanna shift that. We don't care about getting to the floor. We want the back bend to engage the upper back, the whole back, not just this lower back. So come to stand about hips distance apart. Bend in your knees, get loose in your knees. And then tuck your tailbone forward. So I know this looks silly because no one stands like this, but we want to take the lower back out of the equation. So by tucking, we're moving into our glute muscles and that's our anchor. Okay, inhale, reach the arms up. And then exhale, just move the hips forward, send the arms back. Good, and all the way back up. Okay, now this time if you want to start with your hands at your lower back, and you can start to snake the arms down, you might notice that you can go back a little bit further. Now here's the thing. When you're doing that, you can get down a little bit further because your arms are already in the proper like position. The tricky thing is to do that full arm rotation back and then getting into that position. That's hard because that involves a ton of upper body. So we're kind of sneaking around the upper body part a little bit, but still, you need a ton of core to get yourself down there, so we're fine. Okay, so hips distance apart, slight bend in the knees, tucking the tailbone, engaging the glutes, so your glutes should be squeezing. Now you can do the same thing. You can bring your arms up if you want, or you can bring your arms to your lower back. Use those hands to push your hips forward. Gaze comes towards the ceiling, and then maybe moves down towards the back wall. Hands can start to slide from your lower back to your, to the back to your thighs, maybe even to the back to your calf. And up. Good. Now coming up, here's the gauge if you were in your lower back. If you pop up and your back hurts, like even, not like hurts, but you like feel that soreness, then maybe engage a little bit more in the booty, try to bring it more to the upper chest. That's your gauge, because when you're doing this, your lower back shouldn't hurt any more than the rest of the back. So if your upper back feels nothing, and your lower back feels like, ugh, then maybe go a little easy. You might have went a little bit too far back. All right, last time, ready? So the hips distance apart, slight bend in the knees, tuck the tailbone, reach the hips forward, bring the hands to the lower back, gaze comes up towards the ceiling, and then you start to drop back. Picking where you're most comfortable. If you feel it in your lower back, draw the shoulder blades, or not the shoulder blades, draw the shoulders up, if that makes sense. I'm upside down, so hold on. Inhale, come all the way back up. That wasn't the best direction. I lost track of my directions when I was down there. Okay, if you can feel, I'm going to try to explain it. I'm going to go against the wall so you guys can see what I'm talking about. Okay, so if you start to feel like your lower back is taking the brunt of it, you can, that means that you're kind of crunching. So what I meant when I said like back, I really meant like, I don't know how to explain it. Lifting, if that makes sense. So like, imagine there's a string on your head and it's pulling up towards the ceiling. You know, you're pulling away from your lower back. That's what it is. So when you're upside down, instead of crunching in, see if you can lift, like make the spine longer. So you're going long instead of down. It's the same thing when we do our forward folds, and we always say moving heart forward, keeping that chest up, rather than trying to get to the ground. It's the same thing, only in reverse. Keeping the chest open, moving with the spine, keeping it long, keeping it long, keeping it long, and trying not to crunch right in that area. Yeah? Okay. Inhale, reach your arms around and up. Exhale, forward fold. And hang a minute, releasing the lower back, because regardless, it always gets into the lower back. Taking a halfway look up. Exhale, forward fold. Step the right leg back. Step the left leg back, and then bring your knees down, coming back into your tabletop. Right foot comes back, tuck the toes, and then lean into that heel. Give yourself a good calf stretch. Now lift that foot up, bring it over to the left side, and then same thing, lower that heel down, gaze comes over the left shoulder towards that right heel. Giving yourself a full side body stretch. And back up to center. Left foot goes back, drop that heel. You can like push back into the hands a little bit, like you're pushing back towards the foot. So you're trying to get that heel down. I don't know if you can actually get the heel down without lifting the knee. I don't know. Maybe some people can. I don't know if it's possible.
I don't know if it's possible.
Yeah. Lift the back foot up, cross it over to the right, and then gaze comes over that right shoulder as you're looking at that left heel. And back to center. Tuck the toes under. Actually, let's not. Let's move into our fairy dogs really quick to get our cardio up. Okay. If you have never done fairy dogs before, because it looked like there might have been a newer person, a newer name watching, fairy dogs are our prep into our inversions. They are not inversions, so don't freak yourself out. You're not trying to get upside down. You're just working on the lift principle. So when we do a fairy dog, we are engaging our core to lift ourselves up so that we can start practicing that hold. Now, the most important thing here is the arms, because you want to stack the wrist, elbow, and shoulder. So the best way to do that is to lock out the arms. Inside of the elbows is facing out. You bring your hands down. Make sure those inside elbows are facing out towards the top of your mat. Tuck your toes under, lift your knees up. Baby step your feet in as much as you can, because the closer you are to stacking those joints, the easier it is. Reach the right leg up and high, and then shift your gaze to in between your thumbs. Take an inhale as you draw that right knee in into your chest. And then exhale, shoot the foot up towards the sky and take a little leap. So inhale, let me do one without talking because it's really hard to show you guys when I'm talking. Inhale, exhale. Now, your leap does not have to be that high. Your leap could just look like that. And that's fine. So take three on the right side and then take a break. Nice.
Oh my goodness.
Take a break, take a break. We're gonna do the left side together. Nice. All right, Mina, come down before we do the other side. So two things that I've noticed. Everyone bows out a little bit before they leap. It's like the same thing that they're doing with their back leg. They're giving their back leg a little leap. I just realized lately, literally this week, push. Like push down the entire time and it stabilizes you so much more. It's actually crazy because I used to bend too. But if you push against, you give yourself so much more stability. Stability really is what it is. Okay, so coming down onto hands and knees. Or not hands and knees, sorry, down dog. Baby step those feet in. Left leg comes up and high. Bend the left knee and draw it in. Take an inhale, exhale, send it up. Nice, Amina. Inhale, exhale, send it up. And last time, inhale, exhale, send it up. Nice and down. Did you feel the difference?
Yeah.
You looked more...
I don't know, I feel like...
Stable, like it didn't look as wobbly, like you were going to fall on your face. Yeah, all right, taking a child's pose. Tuck the toes under, lift the knees, and baby step the feet to the top of the mat. Take a forward fold, catch your breath. Maybe if you want, you don't have to do this, but if you want, you can stick your hands underneath your feet and try to straighten the legs. It kind of like pulls your shoulders down a little bit. Gives you a nice shoulder stretch and leg stretch. So if you feel like you want to try it, go ahead and give it a go. And release that. Take an inhale, reach your arms around and up. And hands to prayer. Hands are going to come to your hip as you reach your right foot forward. Okay, so we're going to do this sequence very, very slow. And then we're going to speed it up. So right leg comes up. Right leg comes back to a high lunge. Tap it down. Lift it up. Come into your warrior three. And back into your crane. Foot down. Okay, did you get it? So it's crane technique. High lunge. Knee taps down. High lunge. Warrior three. Crane technique. Okay. Right leg comes up. Send it back to your high lunge. Lower the knee down. Lift the knee up. Warrior three. Crane technique. And down. One more time on the right leg. Right leg comes up. Back to high lunge. Lower down. Lift up. Warrior three. Whoa. Crane technique. And down. I was wobbly on that side. Alright. Three on the left side. Inhale, crane technique. High lunge. Lower the knee. Lift. Warrior three. Crane technique. Lower down. Lift up. Send it back to high lunge. Lower the knee down. Lift the knee up, warrior three, crane technique, down, I think we got one more,
yeah.
One more, crane, hold on, crane technique, high lunge, lower down, lift up, warrior three, crane technique, lower down, inhale, reach the arms up, Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway look up. Exhale, forward fold. Step the right leg back. Step the left leg back. Down dog. Take an inhale. And an exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Pull forward to your plank. Hold your plank for 10 seconds. Ready? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower all the way down onto the mat. Inhale, lift up, baby cobra, and down. Inhale, lift up, full cobra, and down. Spatula's round two, right arm up to the side, right ear down. Left leg comes up and over. And down. Left arm out to the side. Left ear down, right arm up, or right leg up and over. And back. Bring that hand in. Coming back into your sphinx. I'm gonna spin around so you guys aren't like looking at my booty. Okay. Right foot comes in. Reach the right hand. See how this feels versus the beginning class? Maybe it feels the same. I hope it doesn't.
No.
Okay. Like, I always like wonder when I say that. I'm like, hopefully this is easier. And release it. Bring the right hand down. Left foot comes in. Left hand comes back for it. And down. Bring the head down to the mat. Tuck the toes. Child's pose. Lift up, down dog. Reach the right leg up and high. Now gaze is at that left foot. Bend the left knee and straighten. Bend the left knee and straighten. Bend the left knee and straighten. Bring that right foot. Step it in between your feet. Lower the back knee down. Taking an inhale here, Anjanasana. Hands come down to the mat. Another thigh stretch, so left hand comes down to the mat, and then opposite hand, so right hand comes back to the left foot. Press against your hand for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release that foot. Just keep that bend in that front knee. Lift the back knee up. Step the back foot forward into your chair. Good. See if you can reach your arms up alongside your ears. I'm like the worst at this. It's so hard for me. And straighten all the way up. Hands come to prayer, heart center as you lower all the way down. Inhale, halfway look up. Exhale, forward fold. Step your right leg back. Lower the back knee down. Sorry, not fold down, no. That's just... and reach the arms up. I tricked you. And hands come down. Keep that right hand down. That right foot comes up. Left arm reaches back for the right foot. Draw it in first. And then press against for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lower it down to the mat. And then bring your hand inside that right foot. Slide your right foot back. So you're on your knees. All right. Now. Today's pose is a funky variation of camel. So we're gonna do our camels a little bit to open up our chest, not too much, because we don't wanna do like a super ton in the back. And then we'll try it's like an arm variation. So we're doing like a mermaid camel, if that makes sense. So we'll see. Okay, you guys know know mermaid, like right when we're in pigeon and we do that like arm thingy? Yeah. So we're gonna do that in camel. So first, we're gonna do a dancing camel on each side. And when we do dancing camel, you have two ways to do it. One, you can have your foot all the way down like that. Or two, you can have your toes tucked under. So whichever one is more comfortable to you, whichever one, you'll figure out which one you like better. Okay. So, left hand comes to left foot, left heel. Right arm sweeps forward to the left. Lift the hips up and then swing your arm back. Okay, now here's the tricky part. Right hand comes back towards the left across the front of the body. So it's like a half circle, it's not like a full circle. All right, switch. So bring your hand, your right hand to the right foot. Left arm sweeps to the right and back. And then back down. Beautiful. All right, now, I don't know, should we try one more camel, like a regular camel? Okay, Mamina's like, yes, okay. So, camel number two, before we get to the pose, same thing. You can be up on your heels, or you can be, you're not really sitting on your heels, so you're either here with your toes tucked under, or you're here with your toes tucked flat, out flat. Benefit to having your toes tucked under, it brings your feet up a little bit closer. When they're down, you're basically bringing your hand all the way down to the mat. When they're tucked under, you're giving yourself a couple inches. All right. Same thing here as we did when we were standing up. Bring your hands to your lower back. Squeeze the elbows close together. Open up the chest. Take an inhale. Exhale. Look up towards the ceiling. And then drop it back, looking back, maybe at the wall behind you. And up. Okay, we're going to try one more time. You can bring your hands all the way down, or you can keep them at your lower back, whichever you want to do. So hands come to the lower back. Press into the lower back. Move your hips forward. Gaze comes up towards the ceiling. And then look back. Maybe slide your hands down to your feet. Maybe slide your hands down to, you know, just down the thigh, whatever you want to do. Inhale. And then exhale up. All right, take child's pose before we move into the pose. And up. All right. Now, when we do this, I think of the best angle. You're gonna bring your right knee like way forward. So it's like the back knee is closer to the back foot, right? It's like staggered. Right foot is further forward. And you're going to lift your back toes up. Okay, now once you're here, see if you can grab the foot. Just because then you can gauge where you need to be. Like, so I'm realizing that my feet are a little bit, or my knees are a little bit too close. I want to step it a little bit further back. But that's just me. So now if I laid it down, then my knee is like literally right in line with my toes. That's just me. You might want that foot in a little bit closer. Okay, lift it up. Grab it with your left hand. All right. You can bring one hand up. Oh, look at you, you're bouncing. Okay, if you want to go next level, you can bring it into the crook of that arm. And same thing, you can bring the arm up. You're still balancing. Or you can try to make the connection. Pull your hips forward, lift the chest up.
Whoa.
And down. Yay, Mina did it! If you can sit at home, take a picture, I wanna see. If that didn't work, you can also take the strap or your leggings and just hook it around that back foot. And it's kind of the same thing that we were doing. You hook it. So you can pull it up, and then you can kind of just work on that balance, or you can just kind of move your hand back and move the straps together, like that, you know? Okay, we're going to try the other foot, and then I have one more variation of it, and then we're done, then we're slowing all the way down. All right.
You call this camel pigeon?
I don't know what you call it.
Okay.
It's like, it's so that's the mermaid bind, is that fine?
No, pigeon.
Mermaid camel?
Mermaid camel.
I guess because it's like the camel, yeah. Like it's like the camel, it's not actually a yoga pose, it's just like very, it's a fun play of a bunch of different poses. So I guess we can call it mermaid camel. Okay, so left foot comes forward, right foot comes up. So that's your first one. So grab that foot and then it'll kind of tell you where you need to be. Like maybe you want to move it back a little bit more. Then once you have it, you can hook in the elbow. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do it on the side. We'll see. Left arm comes up. And then the hands meet. Push the hips forward. Squeeze the booty. Take pressure off the lower back. And lower it down. Nice. How'd you guys do? Hopefully you're still with me. Hopefully you haven't given up. Okay, one more thing each side, just for fun. If you're done, if you're over it, go into child's pose. Not a big deal. At this point, we're just playing. All right, so I'm going to switch sides because I feel like my right side's... I have not done this before. I just happened to see my friend try it after like a backbendy class, and it made me curious to see if I could even do it. So this might be a disaster. All right, so the right foot steps forward, so we're in that low lunge. And then it's kind of the same thing. Well, it is the same thing. You bring the back foot up, reach for it first, see what your grip is there. Work it into the crook, and make the connection. Now this one is way tough on that thigh. It's not even a back bend at this point. It's a super, super, super intense thigh stretch. And down. Yeah, you feel it?
Oh!
Do you guys hear? You know? Yeah, because that one is like, yes, because you're not cool. Really, for some reason, you don't have to lean back as much, I think, because your other foot is forward. So it's a lot less about leaning back for it, and it's a lot more about actually bringing that foot in. So it's pretty intense. We're going to try the other side. This side, I have no idea if I'm going to actually make this happen, but we'll see. Now, as always, really, really quickly, when you're doing anything on that back knee, always try to go back a little bit further so that you're on the top of the knee so that you're not actually on the knee. You want to protect that knee. Bring the back foot in. So my left foot is forward, my right foot is up, and make the connection.
Oh.
And now, actually, when the foot is further back, it's a little bit easier. Yeah. All right. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed that. Let's take a child's pose. And now we're going to do regular mermaids because we did so much in the back. Tuck your toes under, come into your down dog. Hopefully you guys didn't see how I just did that because it was not good. I rolled on my ankles pretty intensely.
Oh.
All right. No, it was fine for me because I was trying to roll them out, but then I just realized that hopefully no one copied me because that was... We're right leg up and high. Bend your right knee. Bring it forward behind your right wrist. Taking a pigeon. All right, now in your pigeon, you have options here. Option number one is two. Bring that right heel towards your left hip. So it's more of like an arrow than it is a straight line. Option number two is to grab up a block if your hip's really popped up and prop it under that right hip. Option number three is to lean over onto the right hip a little bit. If you feel the stretch, just do that. And then option number four is to work that right shin as parallel to the top of the mat as you can. That is like the quote unquote full expression of the pose, but I can't really do it. My hips are not open enough, so I end up rolling a little bit more. So I tend to bring the foot in so that I can square my hips. Take an inhale, walk it out. Get deep, deep, deep into that right hip before we move into our pigeons on this side. All right, now you can stay down if you're done with the back bends and you just want to rest. Go ahead and stay down in your pigeon. If you want to try mermaid in your pigeon, Left foot comes up. Left hand reaches back for it. Move that left foot into the arm. Crease. I don't know. Right arm comes up and high. And then you reach for those fingers. Square off your hips. Try to get your gaze forward towards the top of your mat. Take an inhale. And exhale, lower it all the way down. Now, just for the sake of me trying, you guys can come out of that. But if some of you are really, really bendy, because I'm not totally sure who's watching from home, so if you want to try a full bind, I can't do it, but I can do it with the strap, so I'll show you really quick. You bring your back foot in, tuck that strap around it, and then your arms come up and around, and you work on bringing those hands to the foot. And then you can lower down. We'll do that next class when more people are here because I can help you in it. You remember, what's her face's little girl?
Yeah,
wow, what was her
I
name?
I don't remember her name. Yeah,
I bet Monica's going to know. The little girl.
Yeah.
What was the mom's name? It wasn't, I feel like it was something with an
Myra.
S. Myra. Myra's daughter. Remember her? She was like crazy. She like threw her out. She was so good. Okay. Tuck your back toes under, lift your back knee, send your right foot back, pedal out those feet, and then the left leg comes up and high, bend the left knee, bring it back behind the left wrist. Same thing, just pick your most comfortable pigeon pose, sit nice and tall, and then lower it down, taking a breath before moving into the pigeon. Or the mermaid, sorry, not the pigeon. Her son was so sweet too. Remember when he came once or twice?
Mm-hmm.
They were such a nice family.
I wonder what happened to them. Are they still in Disney World?
I don't know. It's so long, right? Like they could have moved.
Yeah.
Or they're old. Those kids are probably like in high school now. Or middle school.
It has been like
3 years.
3 years.
Yeah. And they were like, they were kind of, the son I think was like in 7th grade. So they just might be, they just might be busy doing high school stuff.
Yeah.
Alright, coming all the way back up. Back foot comes in. Reach back for it first, or just stay in your pigeon. Work it into the crook of the, crook, that's the word, the crook of the arm. Left arm comes up and high. Reaching towards the front of the mat. And lower with control. I'm not even going to try to bind on this side because I know it's not happening. Swing both those feet in front of you. Now bend the knees and step the feet in. Take your hands to the outside edges of the foot. Now I like to curl in, like I like to bring my elbows in, but you might like your elbows out. Doesn't really matter. Just curl in, chin to chest, and then start to move the feet towards the mat. Hopefully that gives you a little bit of a back release. Come back up. Walk the feet out a little bit further. Same thing, curl in. Move the feet down. So you're like resisting. So your feet are resisting your hands. And then last one, if you want to see if you can get your feet all the way down. Press the feet against the hands. Pull, pull, pull. And release, lowering all the way down onto your back. Hug your knees into your chest and do a little bit of rolling here on your back. You can go front to back, like the rocking front and back, or you could just go side to side, whatever feels comfortable, but make sure you're getting kind of on your back a little bit. Give yourself a little bit of a massage. Alright, bring the soles of the feet down to the mat, and just a couple windshield wipers each way. Bring your knees back to center, bump your hips over to the right, lower the hips or the knees to the left, and then twist towards your right, give yourself a little bit of a twist, all to release the lower back, because we did a lot back there. And back to center. Bump your hips to the left, lower your knees to the right, And then gaze towards the left. And back to center. Stretch your legs out along the mat, taking any final shimmies or moves or anything that you might need to do before lowering into your Savasana. Turning in your ankles and then releasing the ankles. Turning in your wrists and then releasing the hands. Take a deep inhale in through the nose. Exhale, let the body become heavy. Deep inhale in through the nose. Exhale, let the body be heavy. Allowing yourself to rest just for a few moments at the end of your class to find a little bit of stillness and to let the body settle. And slowly begin to deepen the breath, drawing breath back into the body, wiggling your fingers and wiggling your toes, reaching your hands above your head, stretching your arms out long. Take an inhale and then exhale, curl your knees into your chest, hugging your knees in. Rolling over onto your favorite side, whatever side that might be. And using that opposite hand to drape across the front of the body, pushing it into the ground to help you sit up. Coming to a cross-legged position at the top of the mat, hands are on your knees, palms up, take a deep inhale, and exhale. Bring your hands to Anjali Mudra, prayer position in front of the heart. Deep inhale here, and exhale in gratitude for your body, for showing up, for practicing. And then extending that gratitude to the roots of yoga, always remembering where yoga has come from and being grateful for all of the yogis that have come before that brought us the practice in the West. Take a deep inhale and exhale it out. Namaste. I welcome you to your practice after the yoga practice. All right, thank you guys. Okay, I'm gonna hit these lights. It's gonna take a moment for the iPad to adjust. But thank you everyone that came. And as always, 6:15 on Mondays, we are here at the Fairview Public Library. So if you'd like to come join, come join. Of course, you're always welcome to join from home. That's why we live stream it. So that's fine as well. I hope you guys have a good night. Thank you everyone.